In this tutorial, I'll show you how to download and install LibreOffice, a free Microsoft Office alternative. Welcome to this video. My name is David and I hope you're well wherever you are around the world. Now, LibreOffice is an open source office like Microsoft Office alternative, and it's backed by just people who want things that are more or less accessible to everyone and open source. Now, if you look at the Discover tab right here, and I'll leave the link in the description below, but the URL to LibreOffice is libreoffice.org, and they do have the writer, more or less like Microsoft Word, Calc spreadsheet for like Excel, Impress, like PowerPoint presentations, Draw. This more or less you can use it for things like PDFs and all that. And then we've got the base, and then we've got math, formula calculator and all that. So probably the most used are the word processor and Calc, which is like spreadsheet, and Impress for presentations. But let's download it, and there's this particular button here. If I click on it, it's going to give us a ton of options, and you can download LibreOffice, LibreOffice for Android, and all the other versions that you might want to kind of use. So I'll just click on download LibreOffice, and once I do that, by default it's going to actually realize what operating system I'm using. I'm on Windows 64-bit. So we've got this option, and you can read the release notes for the latest version of LibreOffice. And as you can see, you can also download older versions, and you can see until what date it's going to be maintained and so on and so forth. Now, there's the source code and also operating systems, Linux, macOS, Windows. So it's available for all that. Therefore, let's download the latest version. And if you click on this drop down, depending on what operating system you're using, if it did not recognize automatically, then you can choose it from there. I'll just click on download. And you also have an option to use the torrent kind of file. But once I do that, it's going to download automatically. And it's about 349 MB. So that depends on that. And you can also check on using BitTorrent to download it, if it may not be accepted, like to download the installation file right there and then. So while you're downloading, you can also consider doing a one-time donation, because as I mentioned, it's open source, it's being done for free. So let's just give it a couple of seconds, and then we're going to install LibreOffice on our computer and then see what it looks like as compared to more or less Microsoft Office application and suits. So there we go. Now that it's done downloading, there we have it, LibreOffice 25.8.1. I'll just open the downloads folder. So there we go. I'll just minimize this. And then from here, I can just right click on it and then click on install. It's going to tell us it's preparing to install and then give you a prompt. Welcome to the installation wizard for LibreOffice 25.8.1.1. So this is more or less a step-by-step. I'll just click on next. So this is a typical, and then click on next. Now click install to begin installation. You can create a desktop shortcut if you want. I'll just undo that. And then there's the option to load LibreOffice during startup. I'll not check that as well. I'll just click on install. And then the program features are being installed. You're going to get a prompt. Do you want to allow this app to make changes to your device? I'll click on yes. It's validating the install. And then it's actually going to ask me to close some of the few applications. Close applications and attempt to restart them. Click OK. So I'm more or less kind of forcing to avoid a reboot of the system right there. So it's copying new files. The installation wizard is complete, and I'll click on finish. And then it has prompted for a restart. I'll just click on no. And then I'm going to restart it in a short while. I've gone ahead and restarted my computer. Now let's open up LibreOffice, and I'm going to type here to search LibreOffice. And when you type, you'll see the app, and then we've got Writer, Calc, Math, Impress, Draw. You can choose the one that you want. Let me just click on app right there. It's going to open up. And from here, you're going to see a more or less a dialog box. where you can see the different applications available. So you can create, you can write a document, Calc spreadsheet, Impress presentation, drawing, math formula, base, database. Let's say write a document. And once you do that, it's going to tell you you're running LibreOffice for the first time. Please take a moment to optimize your settings. So click on next, the user interface. You can see that the tabbed, you can see the different options available right there. Let's say we go with the tabbed, and then we can apply that. And then we go to appearance. Let's just use automatic, apply, and then close. So there we have it. Hello world. Looks really good. Nothing to kinda look very different from Microsoft Word. So that is our first run of LibreOffice. Don't save. And as always, you can always open it up depending on what you want. LibreOffice Draw. And it's going to give you a tip, but you can use LibreOffice Draw to edit PDFs, make PDFs fillable, redact or blackout text from PDFs. But that is a simple tutorial on how to download and install LibreOffice, a free Microsoft Office alternative. I hope this video is of value to you. Thanks for watching.